Hello everyone, this is the maths class for standard 5th. Today we will do exercise 5 of chapter 7. Question number 1 is fill in the blanks. A is 5 upon 7 plus 0 is equal to this. If we add 0 to a fraction, the answer is the fraction itself, that is 5 upon 7. Now 12 upon 17 plus 8 upon 15 is equal to 8 upon 15 plus dash. Students, if in addition the order of fraction can be changed, but the sum of the two fraction does not change, so it will be 12 upon 17. But in subtraction it is not possible. Now number C is 3 upon 13 dash is equal to 3 upon 13. As you can see, the answer will be 3 upon 13 and the fraction is also 3 upon 13. So if we subtract 0 from a fraction, the answer is the fraction itself. Now question number 2 is add 2 upon 3 plus 1 and 1 upon 4. First we convert mixed fraction into a improper fraction. So it should be 11 upon 3 plus 5 upon 4. Only like fractions can be added or subtracted. If they are unlike fraction, we have to convert them into a like fraction. So students, as you can see, the given fractions are unlike. So to make them like, first find the LCM of denominator. So the LCM of 3 and 4 is 12. Let us form equivalent fraction with denominator 12. Now let us take first fraction, that is 11 upon 13. How much multiply in 3 to get 12? It's 4 times. So both numerator and denominator multiply by 4, which is equal to 44 upon 12. Now take another fraction, that is 5 upon 4. So how much multiply in 4 to get 12? It's 3 times. So both numerator and denominator multiply by 3, which is equal to 15 upon 12. Now you can add both the fraction. 44 upon 12 and 15 upon 12. Here as you can see, both denominator are same. So 44 plus 15 upon 12. Now 8 44 and 15, which is equal to 59 upon 12. It should be written 4 11 upon 12. Now 8 9 upon 20, 13 upon 15, 27 upon 30. So the given fractions are unlike. To make them like, first find the LCM of denominator. The LCM of 20, 15 and 30 is 60. So LCM is equal to 60. Let us form equivalent fractions with denominator. Take first fraction, that is 9 upon 20. So student, how much multiply in 20 to get 60? It's 3 times. So both numerator and denominator multiply by 3, which is equal to 27 upon 60. Now take another fraction, that is 13 upon 15. So how much multiply in 15 to get 60? It's 4 times. So both numerator and denominator multiply by 4, which is equal to 52 upon 60. Now take next fraction, that is 27 upon 30. So how much multiply in 30 to get 60. It's 2 times, so both numerator and denominator multiply by 2, which is equal to 54 upon 60. Now you can add both the fractions. Now 27 upon 60, 52 upon 60 plus 54 upon 60. Now 27 plus 52 plus 54 upon 60, which is equal to 133 upon 60. It should be written like 2 and 13 upon 60. Now add 3 plus 1 and 4 upon 9, 2 and 2 upon 3. It should be written like as 3 upon 1 plus 13 upon 9 plus 8 upon 3. So the given fraction is are unlike. To make them like, first find the LCM of denominator. The LCM is equal to 9. So take first fraction, that is 3 upon 1. Now how much multiply in 1 to get 9? It's 9 times. So both numerator and denominator multiply by 9, which is equal to 27 upon 9. Take another fraction, that is 13 upon 9. So how much multiply in 9 to get 9? It's 1 time. So we have to multiply 1 in both numerator and denominator, which is equal to 13 upon 9. Let us take next fraction, that is 8 upon 3. So how much multiply in 3 to get 9? So it's 3 times. So both numerator and denominator multiply by 3, which is equal to 24 upon 9. Now add all the fraction, that is 27 upon 9 plus 13 upon 9 plus 24 upon 9, which is now 27 plus 13 plus 24 upon 9, which is equal to 64 upon 9. It should be written like 7 and 1 upon 9. Now, question number 3 is subtract 10 minus 6 upon 7. Here, we apply same process for subtracting. Now first we find the LCM of denominator. So LCM is equal to 7. Let us take first fraction, that is 10 upon 1. So how much multiply in 1 to get 7? It's 7 times. So both numerator and denominator multiply by 7, which is equal to 70 upon 7. Now let us take another fraction, that is 6 upon 7. So how much multiply in 7 to get 7? It's 1 time. So both numerator and denominator multiply by 1, which is equal to 6 upon 7. Now subtract. Now 70 upon 7 minus 6 upon 7. So that is equal to 70 minus 6 upon 7, which is equal to 64 upon 7. It should be written as 1 upon 7. Question number B is 2 and 4 upon 9 minus 5 upon 12. First, we convert mixed fraction into a improper fraction. It should be written like as 22 upon 9 minus 5 upon 12. So, the given fractions are unlike. To make them like, first find the LCM of denominator. The LCM of 9 and 12 is 36. Let us form equivalent fractions with denominator. let us take first fraction, that is 22 upon 9. So how much multiply in 9 to get 36? It's 4 times. So both numerator and denominator multiply by 4, which is equal to 88 upon 36. Now take another fraction, that is 5 upon 12. So how much multiply in 12 to get 36? It's 3 times. So multiply 3 in numerator and denominator, which is equal to 15 upon 36. Now subtract the fractions, that is 88 upon 36, 88 upon 36 minus 50 upon 36, which is equal to 88 minus 15 upon 36, which is equal to 73 upon 36. It should be written like as 2 and 1 upon 36. Now subtract 2 and 13 upon 36, 1 and 5 upon 9. First we convert mixed fraction into an improper fraction. It should be written like as 85 upon 36 and 14 upon 9. First find the LCM of the denominator 36 and 9. So the LCM is equal to 36. Let us form the equivalent fraction with LCM with the denominator. Now take let us take first fraction, that is 85 upon 36. So how much multiply in 36 to get 36? It's 1 time. So both numerator and denominator multiply by 1, which is equal to 85 upon 36. Now let us another fraction, that is 14 upon 9. So how much multiply in 9 to get 36? It's 4 times. So both numerator and denominator multiply by 4, which is equal to 56 upon 36. Now you can subtract both the fraction. 85 upon 36 minus 56 upon 36, which is equal to 85 minus 56 upon 36, which is equal to 29 upon 36. Now your homework is B, E of question number 2, E, F of question number 3.